fact, it's my favorite program. It's a matter of principles. We have Mr. Mahajan. He's a principal of Sharjah Indian School, Sharjah, UAE. And Madam Sheila Mahapatra from Alliance University, Bangalore. Ma'am, welcome. Sir, Ms. Sheila will be your host. Fine, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
It's a pleasure to have you here today on this program. And I'm Dr. Sheila. I'm heading the Electrical and Electronics Engineering Department at Alliance University, Bangalore.
Great.
Yes. So, sir, to begin with, this COVID-19 pandemic has actually been one of the most challenging situation for government and as well as for people. But if you look at it, there has been a silver lining to it in the sense that there has been a lot of work in terms of innovation and out-of-box thinking to deal with this unprecedented situation. One sector which I truly believe is deeply affected by this pandemic is educational sector, whether schools or colleges. And in fact, the advancement in technology and if you look at the digital platform has enabled us through online sessions to continue with the teaching learning process unabated. What I would like to ask you today is, how do you at your school keep the morale of your employee high during this difficult situation? So when I say employee, I would specifically target the faculties, the teaching staff, who have been facing a paradigm shift in terms of teaching deliverables, considering that earlier it was the classroom mode of teaching and online mode of teaching is a totally different ball game altogether. So can you just throw some light into this?
Yeah. First of all, thanks for calling me on this platform to ADTV and to yourself. Yes, this pandemic, there are a lot of changes happened. But according to me, all those changes are positive. And in the field of education, pandemic is a boon. Now, taking into consideration the morale of teachers, faculty members, when they are shifting from classroom teaching to distance learning, to blended mode, to hybrid learning, or to e-learning. There are certain aspects which at schools we are taking care of. Number one is their physical well-being. And we are continuously discussing with them about their physical well-being. We have provided them the medical insurances and all. And we have created that confidence within them that, yes, we are there, even if the positive, even if COVID-19 is positive for you, just don't worry. We are there medically supporting you from every point of view. So they are physically fit, having that confidence, because the mental peace plays a vital role. Second one is their psychological well-being. So we were discussing with them, yes, it is an age of transformation, and only you can transform yourself, you can change yourself, and we are providing all sort of platforms to you. And third thing is to keep their professional morale high. What we are doing, we have given them the complete ownership on their part and kept the responsibilities on our shoulders. Up to a large extent, we are ensuring even their mistakes and blunders, if they commit, with the assurance that yes, they should not repeat it again. There were some issues in the beginning, teething issues were there, but after that, now they are confident, they are trained, they are upskilled, they are transformed, and to be very frank, they are enjoying the distance learning, and they are proving themselves ki, yes, they are the one who are bringing the change. So psychologically, they are strong. Physically, they are fit. Professionally, they are motivated. They are excited because all the authorities lies with them. Authorities to plan, authorities to replan, authorities to create, authorities to innovate, and they are enjoying. They are telling, we are innovating ourselves. Every day we are seeing our new version. So when that confidence is developed within them that they are seeing their new version every day, they are very much excited, they are very much enthusiastic, and in that way, the things are going on very nicely.
Thank you. Sir, the next aspect which I think we should ponder upon is about the students. Well, for the students, in fact, they are in different age groups, but if you look at the children, they are a little less susceptible to such drastic changes, considering that the pandemic has made them confined to home. And in fact, they must be missing their peer group. They must be missing all the activities which they used to do in the school. So from that perspective, if I look at from a child's point of view or from a student's point of view, how in your school steps are being adapted or taken to provide different sort of excitement to the students and a sense of positivity during this pandemic?
Yeah, again, the same thing. Students, to keep them physically fit, because they are online and they are in front of the screen for a longer hours now, which is not common for them, which actually they were demanding when the classroom teaching was, face-to-face teaching was going on, and we are having apprehension that if the mobile and if the autonomy is given to them, what will happen and what not will happen. But now they are very much comfortable. Yes, we are ensuring all sort of safety and safeguarding measures with respect to the students also. Number one, we have given them a formula of 20-20-20. After every 20 minutes, for 20 seconds, they are moving away from the screen for 20 feet, and movement is there, psychomotor movement is there, cognitive movement is there, thought process is there, that is going on. Second thing is, because of this distance learning, they are owning the responsibility and the owner, academic ownership on their shoulder. They are deciding what to study, what not to study, when to study, and which learning makes them happy. What I mean to say, they are becoming somewhat independent learner.
Yes,
and they are accepting the teachers as their scaffolder only. They are discussing with themselves, they are challenging themselves, they are enhancing their competencies. They are doing a lot of research and they are enjoying in that. When they do the research or when they do the project-based learning, they found that, yes, they have created something new. And when they discuss that thing, a healthy debate happens. And when they discuss that thing, that accomplishment, that winning attitude gives them the next step to go ahead. That is second thing. Third thing, yes, initially there were some teething issues, but now we have found out that Zoom break room. So we break the room, we make 5-6 rooms, and we allow them, okay, you yourself fit into the room, and the what not they are having, fun, discussion, virtual fighting, what not, virtual discussion, virtual group studies, cooperative studies, everything is happening with that Zoom room. Within that, they are singing, they are dancing, they are completing their assignments, and they are lengthening their discussion, which were not actually possible in the classroom, because in the classroom, a class of 30 students. But now when the Zoom break rooms are there, 5-5-5 are divided, and the 5 close friends are sitting together, dancing together, singing together, discussing together, planning together, and enjoying. So that has been also developed. Yes, the third thing is relation with the parents. Now they understood what the utility and what the importance of the parents are, how the parents are taking care of them. So that's a healthy relation, or we can say their relationship has gone to the next level. From the parental bossing, it has converted into friendly parenting at the home. So that is another aspect. They started worshipping the mothers and the fathers, because 24 hours they are with them, they are providing them, they are sharing their success stories and all, and they are helping them. So that is another aspect. Yes, physically, when they are running or whatever, those aspects are yet to be explored. But yes, they are doing a lot of meditation. They are doing a lot of yogas. They are doing a lot of Zumba sessions. dancing session, singing session, instrumentation. And, you know, when they are creatively involved, everything will be taken care of. Heart, hands, and head, when creatively involved. Now, what I mean to say creatively involved, the way we are giving them the assignment. I want to quote one example of one assignment. Last time we have given one assignment that the coronavirus is talking to the earth. So what should be that discussion? Some students have written poem on that. Some students have written an essay on that. Some students have written a drama on that. Some students have sketched the pictures and some students have made the cartoon. And when all came together from the break room and then shown their things, there was lot of learning for us too. The teachers understood in a better way what is the size of the coronavirus, what is the biological aspects, which protein, whether the life is there or not, and what are the effects and what are the side effects. So all those aspects are happening. So now the students from point of view, they are independent learner, they are competency-based learner, they are doing a lot of research, they are owning their academic ownership, they become good kids and behaving properly with their parents, enjoying with the friends also in the Zoom break room. And the assessment is happening as per their mood and as per their thought process. Because it's, again, Google Classroom, objectivity is there, subjectivity is there. Whenever they feel, they give the answer because the time limit has been given to them. And we are asking such type of questions, which is quite open-minded, open-ended question. So for the open-ended questions, they are using resources from here and there, but creating, which is something new, authentic, reliable, and original. And that originality of themselves is bringing some sort of change. So they are also happy.
So, sir, I really agree with you on this point that, you know, the bonding between the children and the parents. I have a son who is a teenager who is supposed to give the 10th board next year. So it has been an extremely challenging time for him as well as for us. I don't know whether he worships, he is worshiping me or my husband. That is, I don't know. But yes, the overall development of children has been more. I believe Corona in that way has been a blessing in disguise.
Blessing, yeah.
If you look at it, look through the history, if you look at Spanish flu or if you look at the plague pandemic, so every such pandemic had indeed brought about an industrial revolution. And in fact, 2020 stands as, the next revolution of the digital revolution, what you call as. So from that point of view, I would like to know what are some of the virtual activities which you will be conducting at your school during this pandemic period?
Yeah. See, recently we started with, initially when we have started with distance learning, we were having apprehensions that, okay, this 9 to 12 will do far better, but the KG, grade 1 and grade 2 and grade 3, they will have a lot of issues. But in actual, the opposite things happened. The KG students are doing wonders. We organize a virtual tour to various countries for the KG students. And those students who has not come to the school at all, KG1, they don't know their teachers. They didn't come to the school at all. But the way they started responding, yes, this is a Burj Khalifa. This is the highest and tallest building in the world. So that virtual tour is working. So that's a new aspect.
Right. That is innovative.
Yeah. For the 9th to 12th, we have started the OLAP. So they are getting the directions from the OLAP and they are doing the experiment with the things available in their kitchen, in their drawing room, in their house. And that way they are by default enhancing the experiential learning. So that is also happening. Third thing, now they understood in true sense what is the importance of hygiene? What is the importance of self-safety? What is the importance of safeguarding himself or herself? They understood that the learning is beyond the air-conditioned classroom. The learning is beyond the notes and the books and the tutorials and the coaching classes. The learning is beyond depending on a particular teacher, on a particular book or particular school or particular classroom. They understood that learning is somewhat in which they have to involve. That is another revaluation. And such type of revaluation making them a futuristic personality. They are now ready to face any challenge which is coming in the future. They are talking about, one girl came to me of 12th standard, sir, okay, this COVID-20, do you think COVID-21 or 22 will also be there in future? Because why are you talking about that? No, we have to prepare from the beginning itself, okay, what sort of scenario will be there. So that is another thing. Third thing, if you go to the IT sector, I'm very, very proud to announce that many IT sector companies has enhanced their variable pay. Instead of 80% or 90%, I got a message from my daughter, Papa, this time our variable pay is 171%. What does it mean? It means the IT companies which are process-based, which are giving the support and the help consultancies, their role is increased and they are doing wonders. So that is another revaluation. It is not the hi-fi buildings. It is not the hi-fi platforms. From home, you can do the wonders because you are not becoming machine. You are using the machine. You are not becoming technology. You are exploring the technology. You are using the technology for creating something new. So that is another revaluation. Otherwise, that corporate sector, a corporate room in which discussion, blah, 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 talking, blah, 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 presentation. But now the things have changed. Languages all of a sudden has lost their importance. And action and acts become so important, which is defining now a student personality, employee's personality, a teacher's personality, and the personality of everyone. Now in true sense, there is no boundary for any country or globe or the village. Now it's become in true sense a global village. Anyone and everyone, anytime and every time can do wonders if he or she has some innovation, some creativity within. So these are the revolution and these are the facts. Now you take the case of banking, the turnover is increased. You take the case of online money transition, it is increased.
Yes.
Again, the banking doesn't depend on bankers. Banking depends on the ethical way of utilizing the money. Right. The definition of money is also being changed. How to utilize that single rupee when you are putting online, when you are paying that thing, how to do that thing. So a lot of changes are happening. No doubt, there are some industries where the things are going worse, but it's a time to explore that. It's a time to find out that. Academically, it is going on fantastic. IT-wise, it is going on good. Technologically, it was going on good. Health and safety-wise, the death ratio has decreased.
Decreased.
Because of the heart attack, less death. Because of the AIDS, less. Because of the malaria, very less. Because of the cough and cold, it is going to vanish. So all those changes prove that it is not the medicine. It is not the doctor. It is not the clinic. It is you and you. And your care which you are taking for yourself is important. So these sort of changes which are constant will bring the change and remain the change. So that's my aspect on that.
Yes, sir. That was so nice hearing you out. You brought out all the positive aspect. So why to call it a pandemic? Let's call it a
I never called it. It's a boon. It's a boon.
I'll add to that. In fact, the earth is now breathing. If you look at Bangalore was known for its climate. And after so many years, we are feeling the same weather that it used to be years back. That's because the pollution has drastically reduced.
Yes, yes.
It was extremely nice connecting with you, sir, today. And again, thank you.
One more point I want to tell you. There was a lot of rivalries taking into consideration the religious and the spiritual aspect. But now each and everyone understood that it is not the prayer rooms. It is the prayer which makes the change. So yes, spiritually also, people become strong. Irrespective of whatever be their religion is there, whatever be the caste, color, and creeds are there, it is not the prayer rooms, but it is the prayer and only the prayer which they are doing with lot of concentration, thinking and thanking about the supreme power of the globe.
So call it by any name, it is just the belief in that supreme, which leads us ahead. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So kind of you. Thank
interacting you. With you. Thank you, EDTV, for connecting us. Thank you.
Thank you.